Привет, and welcome to lesson 19 of my Russian language course. I'm your host, Dmitry Slomov. In the last lessons, we were talking about visiting different places. We also talked about a Russian summer house, dacha. Actually, one may go to dacha not only in summer, but also in winter. This is a very special experience. In winter, when everything is covered with snow, the scenery becomes very special. One may enjoy skiing in the forests, one may sleigh, one may ice fish. There are many ways to have fun. But if you have decided to go to a Russian countryside in winter, make sure that you have appropriate clothing. And if you go with your Russian friends, be ready to drink vodka or other strong alcoholic beverages. In winter, many Russians drink them in order to warm up. So, let's imagine that it is winter time. And Phil, who has arrived to Russia, talks to his Russian friend Ivan. Ivan has definitely decided to go to his dacha on Saturday, and he wants to invite Phil to join him and his friends. So Ivan wants to say, "On Saturday, I go to the country house with my friends." Russians rarely say "I go with friends" or "with somebody." They usually say "we go with friends" or "we go with somebody." So, in Russian way, Ivan says, "On Saturday, we are riding with friends to dacha." On Saturday, в субботу, we are riding, мы едем, to dacha, на дачу, with, с, with friends, с друзьями, Remember, we have said with us, с нами, or with you, many, с вами. So the ending ами remains. And while friends in Russian, друзья, with friends becomes с друзьями. So Ivan says, Привет, Фил. В субботу мы едем с друзьями на дачу. And he wants to propose that Фил rides with them. So he says, Let's ride. Поехали. Поехали. With us. С нами. Поехали с нами. Поехали с нами. Phil wants to ask, and who else will be there? Who in Russian? Кто. Кто. Else, like you mean that there will be other people. There will be actually more people. Ещё. Ещё. The same like still, but the word ещё has many meanings. Among them, more. Ещё. You may say, please give me more. Or in Russian way, to me, please, more. Мне, пожалуйста, ещё. Мне, пожалуйста, ещё. So, will be, one person, будет. There, там. Там. So, Phil asks, А кто еще будет там? Or better, А кто еще там будет? А кто еще там будет? And Ivan tells him, Мы едем с Сергеем, с Таней, с Крисом и с Викой. А еще там будут Петя и Анна. And Ivan wants Phil to decide. And he says, So, are you riding with me? Ну, ты едешь со мной? And Phil would want to take his girlfriend Lisa. So he wants to say, May Lisa also go with us? Or in a more Russian way, like, Is it allowed that Lisa will also ride with us? May, or it is allowed, or is it allowed in Russian? Можно. Можно. It is used similarly to the word давай. For example, if we want to propose that Lisa will go with us, we say давай Лиса тоже поедет с нами. And when we ask, is it allowed that Lisa will also go with us? We say можно Лиса тоже поедет с нами? Можно Лиса тоже поедет с нами? And Ivan replies, of course it is allowed. Of course, конечно, конечно. Ivan says, «Конечно, можно!» Great. Now, Phil asks, «And what shall we do there?» «What?» «Что?» «We shall do» «Мы будем делать» «There» «Там» Phil says, «А что мы там будем делать?» And Ivan says, «We shall go skiing in the forest». «Go skiing» in Russian it is like «ride for fun on the skis». In Russian there are separate words for «ride». When you ride somewhere in order to arrive there, and when you just ride for the sake of riding, for fun. So this sort of fun riding sounds кататься. Кататься. On the skis, на лыжах. На лыжах. So to go skiing or to fun ride on the skis, кататься на лыжах. Кататься на лыжах. In the forest, like somebody will be there, will be in the forest, в лесу, в лесу. Remember how you say to the forest, в лес. Иван says, мы будем кататься на лыжах в лесу. Мы будем кататься на лыжах в лесу. Or he also can say like, we shall go to the forest to ride skis. Мы пойдем в лес кататься на лыжах. Мы пойдем в лес кататься на лыжах. And Ivan wants to add, the forest is very beautiful now. Or in Russian way he says, now in the forest it is very beautiful. Now in Russian, сейчас. Сейчас. It comes from the word for hour, час. In old Russian, it was like in this hour, сейчас. It is beautiful, красиво, красиво. So, if you see something beautiful, you may right away say it to your Russian friends. Красиво. It is very beautiful, очень красиво. Иван says, сейчас в лесу очень красиво. Сейчас в лесу очень красиво. Иван wants to continue. We shall go to the Russian bathhouse. The traditional Russian bathhouse, баня, баня, is actually a wet sauna. It is very popular among Russians. Many build баня at their dacha. Besides the ordinary pleasures of wet sauna, in Russian баня it is common to slap oneself or one another with bunches of twigs. It is considered very good for health, and the twigs of different plants are supposed to cure different illnesses. In winter, it is also common, after having heated oneself pretty good in banya, to go out and roll over in the snow. It is a very special experience. In Russia, men usually go to banya in a men-only company, and ladies go in a ladies-only company. Although naturism becomes more and more popular in Russia, for most Russians, when men and women go together to banya, it may be a clear implication of subsequent relationships. So, when we go to banya, we say в баню, в баню. The word баня is used with the preposition в when we go to баня, or when we are in баня. But the endings differ. To баня – в баню. In баня – в бане. Like today in the evening we are in баня. Сегодня вечером мы в бане. Or today in the evening we go to баня. Сегодня вечером мы идем в баню. To have a steam bath, it is said like to steam oneself. Париться. Париться. So, to have a Russian bath, it is like to steam oneself in a Russian bathhouse. Париться в бане. Париться в бане. Иван says, вечером мы будем париться в бане. Вечером Мы будем париться в бане. And Phil wants to say, oh, how wonderful. It is wonderful in Russian. Здорово. Здорово. How? Как? Phil did not expect that he will be invited to a баня. So for oh, he says ой. Ой, как здорово. He is rather surprised and excited. And this is how you express excitement in Russian. Ой, как здорово. He wants to say, I love to steam myself in a баня. I love, я люблю. Люблю. The beginning of this word is somewhat related to the English word love. Люблю. You may love to do something, or you may love to eat something, or you may love a person. It is all the same. Люблю. Phil says, я люблю париться в бане. Я люблю париться в бане. And he wants to ask Ivan, and what about you? Do you love to go to heat yourself in a баня? You love, любишь, любишь. The ending is similar to будешь, любишь. Phil asks, а ты, Иван, ты любишь париться в бане? Иван says, yes, of course, I love to париться в бане very much. Or in Russian way, я очень люблю париться в бане. Я очень люблю. Иван asks, and Lisa? А Лиса? Лиса любит париться в бане. She loves. Любит. Phil replies, yes, she loves баня very much. She loves баня. Something is being done to баня. And it ends with а. So it becomes баню. Phil says, да, Лиса очень любит баню. Да, Лиса очень любит баню. And Ivan says, fine, you both, or you many, love баня. We love баня. We shall ride to Dacha, and we shall go to steam ourselves to a баня. You many love, вы любите. Вы любите. We love, мы любим. Мы любим. They love, они любят. Они любят. Иван says, хорошо, вы любите баню. Мы любим баню. Поедем на дачу и пойдем париться в баню. Great. Now let's summarize the dialogue between Phil and Иван. Привет, Фил. В субботу мы едем с друзьями на дачу. Поехали с нами. А кто еще там будет? Мы едем с Сергеем, с Таней, с Крисом и с Викой. А еще там будут Петя и Анна. Ну, ты едешь со мной? Можно Лиса тоже поедет с нами? Конечно, можно. А что мы там будем делать? Мы пойдем в лес кататься на лыжах. Сейчас в лесу очень красиво. А вечером мы будем париться в бане. Ой, как здорово! Я очень люблю париться в бане. А Лиса? Лиса любит париться в бане? Да, Лиса очень любит баню. Хорошо. Вы любите баню. Мы любим баню. Поедем на дачу и пойдем париться в баню. Very good. So that's enough for this time. And see you in the next lesson. Пока.